For our first time setup of an iQUBE, after ensuring that all the iQUBE boards in the set have been defaulted as a good starting point, you want to check your dip switch settings. If you find the little serial number label, right above that is a tiny little dip switch rack with two switches on it. Right now, the top switch is over to the 485 side, which we don't address, it's just 422. If you're gonna set it up to the indicator, that's what it's gonna be in the menu. And I have this set for full duplex at current. So it's gonna use a four wire connection, as you can see on the terminal here. For the 1280, you would wanna use a four wire. It's much better supported. If you were gonna use a 920, you can use a two wire. And you can switch the bottom switch over to the left-hand side for a two-wire 422 connection. And of course, if both of those are over to the one side, which is marked 232, then you are in RS-232 mode. Now, the proper way to switch the dip switch settings, if you were gonna change into, say, 232 mode, I would have to move that top switch over. What we're gonna do is throw our switch on the side into config. You're gonna see the load cell lights go out. We're gonna move our switch over. And we can cut the main power coming into the power supply, or we can pull the main daisy chained power coming into your primary board, and you'll have your heartbeat light go out. Restore the power, you'll see your heartbeat return. And move your config switch back to off, and you should have all your load cell lights come back on, and then you'll be in whatever comm setting mode that you selected, in this case 232.